greater about a societal problem. I'll tell you what story does. The case of Jose Garena, a two-tour former Marine who was killed by a SWAT team carrying out a raid in Pima County, Arizona. The police released over 70 rounds in a matter of about 7 seconds, at least 60 of those hitting Garena. And while he bled to death, the police wouldn't allow paramedics to access him inside the house. And at the end of it, no drugs, nothing illegal was found, just weapons and armor that a former Marine may legally possess, as well as a Border Patrol baseball hat that the police tried to claim was a law enforcement uniform. It's a story we began covering here on The Alona Show weeks ago, but now more details have emerged, including a video released by the Department of Police. This, unfortunately, is a scene that we see or read about far too often. Raids gone wrong, turning violent, innocent men and women killed. But they rarely make the news like the Casey Anthonys of the world do. So joining me to discuss why that is Radley Balco, senior writer for the Huffington Post. Radley, always great to have you on the show. Now, you've been covering the story pretty extensively, and the story itself has changed many times. Surprise, surprise. Can you walk us through some of the inconsistencies?
Sure. Well, the Pima County Sheriff's Department originally said that that Mr. Garena had fired at them. They later changed that story to say that actually not only had he not fired, but his rifle was, the safety was still engaged after he was shot. They're now saying this was originally a marijuana investigation. Now they're saying it was part of a home an investigation into a home invasion ring. And they're saying that, you know, he was a potentially a very dangerous person, that he was possibly committing armed robberies. Actually, what they're saying is he was linked to a chain of armed robberies. Last night, they did a big document dump, the sheriff's department did, and, you know, we found basically that some of his relatives may have been involved in some of this activity. But so far, there's no evidence, still no evidence that he was.
The thing is, though, the sheriff's department has even scolded the media for criticizing this story, for criticizing the fact that the information keeps changing, and for questioning whether the raid really was conducted legally. Is that something that, you know, that we see often? Is that a trend when you cover these cases?
Yeah, it's typical. I mean, what they do is when people start asking questions about one of these raids and they start pointing out inconsistencies in the police story, they do a couple things. First, they go into kind of a bunker mentality and they start cutting off information flow. In this case, they've sealed the search warrants and the police affidavits that that led to the raid. And then they also do kind of a leaking smear campaign against the person who was killed in the raid. And this, we've seen it in this case with Mr. Garena, who, you know, had no prior criminal record. Again, nothing illegal was in his home. But, you know, I mean, even if he was part of this home invasion ring, I mean, this was a really sloppy, careless, unprofessional raid. I mean, if you look at that video, I've actually talked to some former military people who carry out these raids and train people to carry them out in Iraq and Afghanistan over the last 24 hours or so. And they told me, look, I mean, we show way more caution and way more sort of consideration for the possibility of innocence in these buildings when we carry out raids on a battlefield. You know, and these are U.S. citizens who ostensibly have constitutional rights, and people in the military who have seen these raids, who've seen video of this raid, are sort of astounded by what they see. And one said it was sort of like a Keystone Cops looking scenario. If it, you know, it would be funny if it weren't for the fact that it, you know, someone actually died in this.
Well, that's the part I find so bizarre, is you could say that easily the police will often just release their side of the story or the little bits of information that make them look good. I wouldn't say that this video makes them look good. Why do you think they decided to put it out there?
I think they think it makes them look good. I mean, there is a siren that goes off for about 8 seconds, and you do see them actually knock and announce themselves. But, you know, if you sort of watch that video and put yourself in Mr. Garena's shoes and imagine you're asleep after working a graveyard shift, and ask yourself, you know, you're behind a couple of walls, or, you know, a couple of walls separate you and these police officers. To ask yourself, would you have known that these were cops outside of your home, or would you have thought, you know, there are people there to do you harm? But I mean, if you think about this, I mean, they unleashed 70 rounds into a home where there was a 4-year-old child inside, which they didn't know about, which says a little bit more about their investigation, I think. We also now know that they raided or broke into a house across the street afterward because they found bullet holes in the side of that house, which, of course, were from their own guns, their own bullets, and were worried that they had hit somebody in the house. So then they break the door down to that house and storm that house. You know, what if somebody had been in that house with a gun as well? I mean, it is so incredibly sloppy and dangerous. And I mean, this is a tight neighborhood. It's the houses are close together. I mean, it was wrong on so many different levels, even if Garena was the suspected criminal they make him out to be. And I'm not yet convinced that he was.
And, you know, it's a grave offense either way. This is the death of an American citizen at the hands of authorities. And you and I talk about this all the time. This definitely isn't an isolated incident. But how come this doesn't get the media coverage that, say, the Casey Anthony trial does, where the media feels the need to cover it 24 hours a day, nonstop, update you on every move that she makes when she's inside of the courtroom?
You know, I don't know. I mean, I think part of it is kind of deference to law enforcement, deference to government on the media, by the media. I think there's a hesitancy to sort of question the police a lot of times. You know, you're dealing with somebody who the police are saying is a suspected criminal, so there's not the sort of natural sympathy that people might have, that they would have for a child. And also, you know, I mean, there's just, again, the sheriff's department is holding back information, so... You know, the story here right now is how little information there is, which, you know, doesn't make for good television, I guess.
Well, if we're talking about what makes good television, I want you to be honest. What do you think? Do you think that his story is even getting more attention than it normally would because he is a former Marine, because he's a veteran who served two tours? I mean, how often do these stories go completely unreported? You know, how often do we see, let's say that if it was a black woman killed somewhere or a black woman that killed her daughter, it probably wouldn't be getting the same type of, attention that the case of Casey Anthony is because she's an attractive white woman.
Yeah, I mean, I think there's definitely something to that. I mean, when Shai Calvo, the white upper middle class mayor of a town in Maryland, was wrongly rated, it made international news pretty much overnight. But also, I mean, when Katherine Johnston, the 92-year-old grandmother in Atlanta, was killed in a botched raid, that made national news, you know, pretty quickly. But no, I think you're right. I mean, there is something about the victim in these raids, and if it's a young sort of single black male, people are less ready to believe that, you know, this is an outrage or that the person was innocent, even if they were.
All right, Bradley, I want to thank you very much for joining us and filling us in on this story. And the details are still slowly coming out, although, as we know, those affidavits, the search warrants are still sealed. And we'll see if we get any transparency in that case at all. Thanks so much.
Yeah, thanks for your coverage of this. It's important.